Hello everyone, my name is Fazal. You are watching MFA Civil Engineering. There are various type of the equipment which are used for the excavation of the earth, like power shovel, backhoe, drag line, clamshell and trenching machines. Power shovels are one of the most long lasting and useful class of the earth moving equipment. It is one of the basic equipment employed to excavate the earth and to load the truck. Power shovels are capable of the excavating all type of the earth except hard rock. It may be a crawler mounted or the wheel mounted. Crawler mounted have a low speed but very effective in unstable soil. On the other hand, wheel mounted shovels have a high speed and are effective only for the firm ground. The size of the power shovel depend on the type of the work. The size of the bucket or the dipper denotes the size of the power shovels. The size of the power shovels varies from 0.375 meter cube to 5 meter cube. The basic part of the power shovels include the track system, cabin, cables, rack, stick, boom foot pin, saddle block, boom point sleeves and the bucket. These parts for the cable controlled shovels with a divided stick with a rack. The working of a power shovel in a such a way that the power shovel is moved into the required positions such that the excavation face is within the reach. Then the bucket stick is lowered and cables are moved such that a bite is made into the ground. By moving the bucket forward, the earth get excavated and get filled in a bucket. Then the bucket is swung back to the required positions and by opening the flap, the excavated earth is unloaded into the waiting trucks. In this way, the process is repeated. Power shovel is a most suitable equipment for the close range of the work. It is capable of digging a very hard materials and can be removed big size of the boulders. It is used in a various type of the jobs such as digging in a gravel bank, clay pit, digging cut in a roadwalk and the roadside bumps. The output of the power shovels depend on the class of the materials, depth of the cuttings, angle of swing, job conditions, management conditions, size of the hauling units, skill of the operators and the physical condition of the shovels. Backhoe is also termed as the hoe, back shovels and the pull shovels. It is an excavating machines of the power shovel group. It is generally used to excavate below the natural surface on which it rests. Backhoe are used to excavate trench, pit of the basement and generally grading work which required a precise control of the depth. It also removed the earth as it cave into the ground to establish a natural slope. The basic part of the backhoe include the boom, jack boom, boom foot drum, boom sleeves, stick, bucket and bucket sleeves. The working operations of the backhoe is most similar to that of the power shovels, except that in backhoe, the digging actions result from drag or pull of the bucket toward the machines, unlike the shovels that make outward stroke while digging. The machine is placed in operations by setting the boom at a desired angle. Then the hoist cable is pulled in and the drag cable is released, thus moving the dipper to the required positions. The free end of the boom is lowered by releasing the tension in the hoist cable until the dipper teeth bite into the ground and pulling the cable, the dipper is filled. The dipper is lifted by rising the boom and then swing to the dumping positions. Backhoe is not efficient as the power shovels. It is most suitable machines for digging below the machine level, such as trench, footings and the basement. The drag line is named because of its prominent operations of dragging the bucket against the material to be dug. Unlike the shovels, it has a long light crane boom, and the bucket is loosely attached to the boom through the cables. Because of these constructions, drag line can be digged and dumped over the large distance than the shovels can do. Drag line are useful for digging below its track level and handling of soft materials. The capacity of a drag line is indicated by the size of the bucket in a cubic meter. Drag line can be crawler mounted, wheel mounted, or the truck mounted type. The basic part of the drag line include the boom, hoist cable, drag cable, hoist chain, drag chain, and the bucket. The working operation of a drag line is in a such a way that the bucket is lowered in a fully dumped positions by releasing both hoist and the drag cables till it rests on the ground with teeth dig into the earth. The hoist cable is slackened slightly and then drag pulley is applied. These actions fill earth in the bucket and then bucket takes in a horizontal positions. It is then hoisted. When the required dumping height is attained, the boom is swung to the position of the dumping and drag brake is released. This will dump the load of the bucket. The boom is then swung back to the digging positions and the same cycle of the operations are repeated. Drag line is the most suitable machines for digging of soft materials and below its track level. It is very useful for excavating a trench. The output of the drag line depend on the size and type of the buckets, length of the crane boom, type of the materials, angle of swing, depth of cutting, working conditions and maintenance of the machines, size of the hauling unit and methods, and skill of the operators. Clamshell is named due to the similarity of its bucket to a clamp, which is like a shellfish with a hinge double shell. The front end is essentially a crane boom with a special design bucket, loosely attached at the end through the cables, as in a drag line. The capacity of a clamshell bucket is usually given in a cubic meter. The basic part of the clamshell bucket are the closing line, hoist line, sleeves, buckets, tag line, shell, and the hinges. The working operation of the clamshell is in a such a way, the clamshell bucket is brought over the locations where the material is to be dug. The bucket is lowered with the shells open till the good contact is made with the ground. Now, the buckets are closed in through the closing line. As the two shells close in, the weight of the bucket enable it to dig into the materials, therefore filling the bucket. Then it is hoisted and swung to the position of the dumping and the earth are dumped. The boom is then swung back to the positions and the same cycle of the operations are repeated. Clamshell are commonly used for handling a loose materials like crushed stone, sand, gravels and the coal. The main function of the clamshell is a vertical lifting of the material from one location to the another. Clamshell are mainly used for removing a material from coffer dam, sewer manhole and the well foundation. Trenching machines are used for excavating a trench for laying pipelines, sewerers and the cables. Their operation is quick, giving the required depth or the width. There are two types of the trenching machines like wheel type and ladder type. Wheel type trenching machine can be used for providing a depth up to a 3 meter and width ranging from 0.3 meter to 0.6 meter. This machine consists of a power driven wheel provided with the number of the detachable bucket having a cutting teeth. The earth picked up by the bucket is deposited on the belt conveyor, which discharges the earth to the other side of the trench. Ladder type of the trenching machine consists of the telescopic ladder or the boom. There are two endless chains on which detachable buckets are mounted. The boom is holding the chains. The excavated materials is conveyed to the conveyor belt, which dispose of the excavated earth to the two sides of the trench. With the help of the gears, the speed of the machine can be adjusted. This machine can be used for excavating up to a depth of 10 meters and a width of 3 meters. This machine is not suitable for the muddy or the rocky soil.